I gotta tell you, I recommend. There's also one on Spring Mountain, Chinatown. Trooper. Yo, today is Wednesday. Time to go out and play the pokers. Go to the strip, see Vegas, do whatever it is that I do. By the way, did you catch the live stream from last night? One tournament, one win. I'm really digging the live streaming of the online poker. Probably should have started doing it a long time ago, but I just wasn't motivated to do that, but now I am. So we'll do it while I'm motivated, but right now, this place, Christina and I came here a couple days ago. It's called Seven Leagues Cafe. Really good coffee, so I had to have one today. Let's go. Right when they make the drink, they put it through this machine and seal the top so you can shake it. Shake it, don't break it. It took your mom and I must to make it. Oh man, that's really good. It's a little sweeter than what I normally get, but for some reason it works. This is the house coffee. It's supposed to have what they call sea cream on top of it, which is a salted whipped cream. But when we got it the other day, it was just too much salt, way too salty. So I just got no salt. Next time I might get just a little dollop of the salt. New coffee spot right here. Like Asian style, Vietnamese coffee, Thai tea, all kind of stuff like that. Made it on down to the strip. I gotta tell you, I recommend Seven Leaves Cafe. There's also one on Spring Mountain, Chinatown. I was gonna park at the Mirage because I gotta meet someone over at Harris. And you know what, let's go to the street. Let's walk outside today as much as possible. But the Mirage Garage is closed for some reason. You know what, this used to be really good, but it now sucks ass. Like it's really bad. It's not just not as good as it used to be, like it's really bad. It really fucking sucks. It tastes like basically a piece of cardboard with more cardboard on top of it. Hey, I tell it like it is. It's not a complaint. I tell it like it is. That's it. As I was pulling in to try to park at the garage at the Mirage, I was thinking about it. I was like, man, it's been a while since I walked through this little area of the Mirage property, you know, where you don't go through the casino but go through the grounds of the Mirage. All tropical looking, kind of almost feels like you're somewhere that isn't Vegas. I mean, the cake looks good. It's $9. They got it in a vending machine. It's got to be better than the pizza. Their pizza is pure trash. Trash, I tell you. Just like Francesco's is trash. Just like Moneyline is trash. Shout out to Kevin, who I just met over at Harris. Thanks for taking the hats home. Thanks for watching the videos. Oh shit, I just realized something. I called and put my name on the list at Venetian. Gosh, what time did I call? If I fell off that list already, what time I call them? Oh shit, 1:56. I got 7 minutes to check in so that I don't fall off the list at Venetian. They have way more games than everybody else because of the promotions. And even though this is not my favorite place to play, damn it, didn't I say I wasn't gonna play here anymore? There's only like three. There's only three games at Caesars. It's Wednesday, so Planet Hollywood's not open. Bally's is not open. I don't think the Flamingo is open, right? You got Caesars, you got Aria, you got Bellagio. I think MGM Grand opens at 4. Shit is so locked down and limited. Even though we're not locked down, it feels like we're locked down. I was this close to staying home and playing online today. Last night was so much fun. One tournament, $15 bounty tournament, 176 players, $5 per bounty. I ended up with 9 bounties plus my own because I won the tournament. So I get $50 back for bounties, $432 for first, and it was a lot of fun. And I had fun on Sunday too. Is it quiet out here? I mean, it is super quiet. Speaking of Super Bowl weekend, right? I think a lot of people are probably going to come in town for Super Bowl weekend, don't you think? You would think so. Which way is the wind blowing? The wind has been messing up the audio, I'm sure, this whole entire video. I know the list for Trooper Thursday is longer for tomorrow than what we have been having. And I think several of those people said that they were coming in town for the Super Bowl. So I don't know, it kind of gave me the impression that there will be people coming in town for the Super Bowl. So I just cashed out of the game at Venetian. Gotta say, the game was fairly decent. If it wasn't for the wind, it would be dead silent out here, wouldn't it? Game was fairly decent. One lovely hand that I played, I had two kings in the big blind, 1-3, folded to the cutoff, who made it 6, the button called 6, small blind folded, and then I made it 26. To my delight, the cutoff called and the button called. The flop was 10-4-3. I led out for 40. I got a call from the cutoff. The button folded. Look at that jackass with no lights. Look at him. I don't know if you saw him or not, but let me give you a little tip from your Uncle Trooper. We pause the poker story and give you a life lesson. When you're driving in a well-lit area, you still need to have your lights on at night, because it's not about you being able to see. Even if you can see fine with no lights on, it's not about you being able to see. It's about other drivers being able to see you. One of the stupidest things that I see all the time here in Vegas, because there are so many lights, is people driving around with no friggin' lights on. The turn was another 3. I led out for $90. The cutoff had about 2 around 200. I let out for 90, and he agonized over the decision and made the call. I then pushed forward about $180 to shove all in blind before the river card came out. I'm glad I did that. The river card was a king. Because of the all the plexiglass, I didn't make out everything he was saying, but from what I gather, I think it was good that I bet blind, because I think that, because I heard him say something like, you bet before the king came out, which means the king might have deterred him a little bit. So again, on the river, he thought about it for a while, and I think his gut told him don't put it in, but he put it in. So that was a nice hand. After all the smoke cleared, I win 252. And shout out to Bike King. You've probably seen Bike King's videos before. The guy who lives in his car. You know what? I didn't ask him if he still lives in the car, but I think he does. Look at this creepy ass empty level 5 of the Treasure Island parking garage. Creepy. Go Gamble Blend should be ready any day. So hopefully, if you've ordered Go Gamble Blend, I should be shipping it out. I'm hoping to be shipping it out before the end of the week. Yo, remember, if you like my videos, click the thumbs up button. Make sure you subscribe. Tell your friends about the videos and leave a comment down below. Look at this wind. You got palm trees going like that? It ought to be a hurricane. Can we have a hurricane in the desert? I'll see you next time.